Handshake line at the end of a series is one of hockey's most time-honored traditions. But as reported by TSN's Darren Dreger, Canadiens forward Dale Weiss alleged that Milan Lucic threatened both Weiss and Alexei Yemelin in the series-ending cue.
Set on the ice, so it'll stay on the ice. So if he wants to be a baby about it, that's he can make it public.
The reportedly bitter end to this series was a continuation of 7 games worth of hatred between ancient rivals. Stick work to tender parts. Goal celebrations that ended up being mocked. Taunting from both sides. A water bottle spraying incident that earned Sean Thornton a fine. Moments which the Canadiens used as motivation.
They're a classy organization, but they gave us a lot of reasons sometimes to compete a little bit harder and to make sure we were winning battles. And, you know, as a player, I know that I'm a guy that feeds off of that. And I know we have a bunch of guys in here that feed off of that as well.
A lot of them had a lot to say about disrespect. They felt that fueled them.
Disrespect? I don't know what they're talking about, disrespect. Having a goal celebration, what kind of disrespect is that?
The pounding of the chest, people that have been here have seen us do that all year because it's related to Boston Strong. Our guys, you know, take some pride in what's happened at Boston Strong, and unfortunately, everything we did seemed to be seen as disrespect.
From a pure hockey perspective, Daniel Briere added to his reputation as a clutch playoff performer. With an assist on Weiss's goal on Montreal's first shot of the game and a late fluky power play goal off Zdeno Chara, Briere started and finished the Canadian scoring.
I know a couple guys that played with Danny before he got here, and when they told me about him in the summer, this is exactly how they explained him. He's a monster in the playoffs. He's clutch.
Including the Sochi Olympics coronation game. And during the second intermission, in a rare moment for the soft-spoken goalie, Price stood up and addressed his teammates before heading back out for the third period.
I don't remember exactly the words that he used, but something about enjoying the moment, not being afraid, and just go out there and have fun and enjoy it.
I can't say I've ever heard him talk, to be honest with you, in a game. So for him to step up and say something like that, I think that really set the tone for our team going to the third.
John Luke, TSN, Boston.
Staples founder Andre Kopitar's wraparound slides up to Drew Doughty. He lets a shot go, but John Gibson dives across with the glove. Gibson takes a puck, fights through the screen from his own defenseman, and Gibson makes the save. The highlight of the night. Stick around. He certainly is popular when it comes to his play because nobody can beat him on this thing.
He's a 1v1 king, but this one might be the one that trumps him. Jordan Gibson, who has been outstanding so far in these playoffs. Yeah, he lost today. But check out the stop here. The wraparound. This is not John Gibson. This is actually from the other game. But if you go on our website.
Oh, good. Yeah, Valdor, I believe.
It will be John Gibson.
Yeah, here we go.
Here's your champ. Here's your champ. That is PK Subban. Very nice. So, anyways, you can go on TSN.ca and vote for that.
It's a one-goal game in the seventh game of the playoffs.
Bitter rivals and the two best words in sports.
Montreal-Boston, Game 7.
Another chapter is written in their historic rivalry.
Is that the next goal?
Down and out at home, could the Bruins salvage their season with another Game 7 comeback?
Oh, and it's hit the post on a try from McGinley!
SportsCenter begins with Game 7 Canadiens Bruins. It is the ninth time in NHL history that the two original six rivals have met for Game 7. Montreal has won 5 of their prior 8 Game 7s, just over 2 minutes into this one.
Fed on to Briere, side the net, score! Dale Weiss on a pass from Danny Briere. The Canadiens strike first in Game 7, 2-18.
The team that scores first in the second round of these playoffs are 23-1. A little later on, Brad Marchand gets shoved into Carey Price, but he gets called for goalie interference. Marchand irate with the call on the shoot to go. Patrice Bergeron forces the turnover. Marchand alone in front, but he fires it high. Canadiens up by 1-1. Opening seconds of the period, Marchand snows Carey Price. He gets called for unsportsmanlike conduct on the play. So Julien can't believe it. Now, the referees in this game are the same as Game 2 when Julien said the Bruins dealt with a lot of crap after Marchand's penalty expires. He ties up Josh George's, allowing Patrice Bergeron to pick up the puck. 2-on-1 Bruins he keeps, but he's going to be stopped by Price. Midway through the frame we go. David Desharnais pokes the loose puck, feeds Max Pacioretty. He beats Tuukka Rask. Make it 2-0 Canadians. Back in Montreal, a sold-out Bell Center celebrating Patch's second goal in as many games. Under 5 to go in the frame. Pacioretty gets called for holding the stick, sending Boston to the power play. Ensuing man advantage we go. Milan Lucic keeps the puck in. David Krejci leads it for Tory Krug. His shot deflects off Jerome McGinley and in his fifth of the playoffs. Lead promptly cut in half after two periods of play. Now, Carey Price, 4-0 this season in elimination games, including the Olympics. 5 minutes into the third we go. Aginla gonna find Krejci, but Price turns him aside. Aginla then hits the post. The Bruins inches away from the tying goal. Then, final 5 minutes, Michael Bournival chips it by Johnny Boychuk. Boychuk takes him out. He gets called for interference on the play, so ensuing power play. Under 3 minutes to go.
Into the Boston zone. In front to Daniel Breer. Scores! Daniel Breer throws it on net. It goes off the leg and in behind Rask. And the Canadians take a 3-1 lead.
Final minute to go with the Boston net empty. Now 6-on-4 Price goes to clear the puck. Bounces off PK Subban. Just misses the net. Dying seconds we go. Dougie Hamilton over to Marchand. Price with his 29th save to end it as Montreal closes it out. The Canadiens eliminate the President's Trophy winners. Now in the handshake line, keep an eye on Dale Weiss. As he and Lucic actually exchange words. Weiss said after that Lucic threatened him as Montreal moves on to the Eastern Conference Final for just the second time since 1993. So Carey Price wins his fifth straight elimination game, including his time with Team Canada in Sochi. In those five games, Price allowed a total of 2 goals. Montreal finishes the series with 8 of the last 9 goals scored in this one. Montreal is now 5-1 in game sevens since 2004. Now, after the win, PK Subban spoke with Pierre Maguire regarding moving on to the conference final.
We have a great opportunity to do something special here. I told guys before the game, you know, moving on to the third round, you guys have no idea what this city's going to be like. And I feel sorry for the team that's got to come into our building now.
Congratulations. We'll see you Saturday afternoon in Montreal for game one of the Eastern Conference Final, PK.
Yeah, baby.
This is a great accomplishment from that group. And we just beat the best team in the league.
We said that you had some stuff to say in the handshake line. What did you say and why would he say
it? It's set on the ice, so it'll stay on the ice. So if he wants to be a baby about it, he can make it public.
We didn't, well, you know, we didn't get it done. It sucks right now. And, you know, it's as good as team as I've ever played on.
Just tough to swallow. I mean, we have such a good team that for to even think that our season is over right now is, you know, it's just trying to process it because we have such a good team that it shouldn't be.
So this was the scene outside the Bell Center following.
Woo! Look at this, Daryl.
Thousands of fans flooded the streets of downtown Montreal. The police were out in full force to keep order as riots had broken out after past postseason triumphs. But the Habs faithful celebrated peacefully into the night. Just some very happy Montreal Canadian fans as we say welcome to sports and everyone.
Right to the very end, Darren, and I'm Milan Lucic, and he believes that Alexei Yemelin was also threatened. Now, you can understand or perhaps appreciate what was fueling Milan Lucic at the end of that game and the conclusion of the series. This man's a fierce competitor, and he was motivated by anger and disappointment. But I'm going to get into the specifics, but if you watch the video closely, you can probably read Milan Lucic's lips. He felt that he was threatened. He was somewhat amused by it, but also felt that, you know, the level of disrespect for Milan Lucic and the Boston Bruins in this 7-game series was highly motivating.
And all the Lucic pounding his chest after scoring an empty net goal, the Canadians respond with a huge win in Game 3 at home. In Game 5, Sean Thornton sprays PK Subban by the bench. Again, they respond with a huge win in Game 6. And then when Zdeno Chara, 6'9", punches Mike Weaver at 5'10", a generous 5'10", in the face at the end of Game 6, they respond again with a huge effort in Game 7. So, to me, the Canadians responded the right way to all the Bruins' antics.
They weren't saying that to the cameras or to the media, but behind closed doors.
More stable, and what's most important is he stood up in the room between the second and third period of Game 7 and spoke to the guys to enjoy the moment. And this is huge leadership that I haven't seen a lot in my career from goaltenders. They usually stay on their own, but this is the kind of stuff that Patrick Roy and Marty Brodeur were made of, and Carey Price.
Montreal as they move on to the Eastern Conference Final.
All right, thanks very much, gentlemen. I'm going to go now to the Ducks and the Kings. Game number 6, Anaheim. Playoffs, midway through the first.